Hey guys, it looks like we made it. We're right here on the threshold of 2021, here at the end of 2020. God has truly been faithful.
Yes, he has. Yes, he has. I know you can testify to that, church, just like we can testify to it. God has been so faithful as we've walked through a really crazy, crazy year, but God has been so good and so faithful, and we have all now culminated at this point, just minutes away from the change of 2020 to 2021.
You know, around October, I always just purpose to begin to start saying just occasionally and then more regularly, hey, we're going to finish strong because we're in the last quarter of the year.
Yeah.
And, you know, now we're at that point where we're not only making the declaration, but now we're taking that strong step forward in faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. And faith requires us to move forward because movement is life. And so we're believing not only that God has brought us to this point, he's allowed us to come through. We're coming through and out of 2020 strong. But moving into next year, 2021, believing that God has already not only brought us here, but he's also going before us. And so we're thankful. And you know, one way to express thanks is through praise and worship. And we're just so honored. Been so great this year to see how the team, as well as Renee and Alan and their leadership with Hope and Life Worship, our musicians, our vocalists, everyone to be a part of not only helping us lead worship there at the church, but then in the transition of going to fully online and then being in the parking lot. And now here we are.
Incredible.
And now here we are at this New Year's Eve service, this time we have together to bring in the new year. And we can't think of anything better than right now is to have Hope and Life Worship lead us in worship as we just make room for the presence of God, as we know he is faithful.
Amen.
Hello, Hope and Life. Come on. We are ready to worship today. God is good. Amen. Amen. He is awesome today. I hope you have had a great week and now you're ready to bless the Lord. Come on, gather the family around. Gather everybody. Let's praise the Lord today. Amen. Because he's good. Amen. And his mercy is new every morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Woo. Yes. Thank you, Father.
There is no fear, because I believe. There is no doubt, because I have seen your faithfulness, my fortress, over and over and over.
And I have a hope found in your name, and I have a strength found in your grace. Your faithfulness, my fortress, over and over.
Never fail. Your name is powerful. Your words are sound.
stand here and we can declare, I seen you move. You move the mountain. And I believe, come on, I'll see you do it again. You made a way where there was no way. And I, come on, sing it that again. Come on. I'll see you do it. I'll see you move.
Woo.
Oh God, hallelujah. Just worship him. Come on, and just love on him just for like 30 seconds more in your home. Come on, love on him and just tell him how much you love him. Tell him how much you believe in him. Hallelujah. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. He cannot forsake you because he's your Father today. He's your God today. Hallelujah. We believe, Father. We believe.
Hey guys, I know you thoroughly enjoyed that. You know, the Bible talks about the power of praise, that we enter into his gates with thanksgiving, into his courts with praise, and then he inhabits the praises of his people. And so all that does is prepare our hearts, your hearts as well, as we're finishing this year, moving into the next year, for really what God has to speak to us on this day, December the 31st, New Year's Eve. What does the Lord want to say at the end of probably the hardest year that any of us have really truly experienced? I know collectively what all of us have experienced, but you know what? God is not absent. Not only has he not been absent this year, but he's not absent at this last moment. I think for those of you that are watching and receiving this, ready to speak something to your heart, I think, to allow you to cross over in power.
Amen. I believe that. You know, we've talked for years about how it's important to rehearse the blessings. You know, I know this year's been hard for all of us for many reasons, but I think it's important that we rehearse the blessings. There have been blessings that have happened in this time and in this year. I know for us, we have added someone to our family, our son-in-law, our new son-in-law, and there's been some really great, amazing things God's done, and I think it's important for us to rehearse those blessings. But as we're getting ready to go into the Word, I know you've got something powerful for us today.
Well, I want to hope so. I mean, you know, I believe God has really spoke something to me. And honestly, I'm not trying to tease you into the new year, January the 3rd, but I do know that the Lord challenged me to speak on January the 3rd, that first Sunday. We're only going to be online. We'll not have an in-person service. It'll just be online.
Yeah.
But I want to speak about crossing over into the promise. I believe there are some promises that God's wanting us to cross over into the new year and receive, but also walk in the authority of.
Amen.
So cross over into the promise. But it's unique the way the Lord's dealt with me in the fact, and I say that, you know, with great reverence. I'm not trying to say God's this or God that. I don't want to use that as some way to manipulate. I mean, I really feel the Lord has challenged me to speak something specific. Gwen and I, you know, for the new year, January the 3rd, about crossing over into the promise. But just when I felt that leading, I also felt, well, there's some things. I almost feel like the Lord's just downloading, saying, well, to cross over and get into those promises, you got to let go of some things on this side.
Yeah.
You know, Joshua chapter 3, verse 1 through 17, talks about how the Joshua generation gets right up to, and it's because Joshua and Caleb, that were of the former generation now that had all died out, but now they're right there on the edge. They've been there many times before because the area they were circling, the area they were stuck in, if you will, for those 40 years was very close to the promise, but they never crossed over. They were not ready. They had to hear this, let go of some things so that they could fully move into. Because as we began saying early in the year, movement is life. God is a move forward, movement God. There is authority in moving forward. Faith even is a movement. It's not something you sit there still in. Even if you feel stuck in your circumstance, faith keeps you persistently leaning into God. So there they are many times right there at the edge of their breakthrough, but they're not ready because they're not ready to let go of some things. They got too much Egypt in them, too much of the past in them, and God had to get that out of them so he could get them over into the new thing. And so in Joshua chapter 3, verse 1 through 17, they're now at the Jordan River during flood stage, where it's the most impossible moment to cross over. But just as they came through the Red Sea, of course, the former generation, it was a sense of baptism. Now this is a sense of baptism for this new generation to cross over. But as they were crossing over and getting ready to cross over, as I said, I felt there were some things that we as well are crossing over, a sense of baptism coming out of 2020 into 2021. You know, that there's something in our heart where we don't want to be, you know, baptism, what is an indication of what? It's an outward expression of the internal work of God.
Right?
Right. I mean, it's saying, I have died out to the old.
Mm-hmm.
And help me now. What does it mean? It means to what? Come to life.
And then being raised, in the new life.
Yeah. And honestly, that is what I believe that coming out of 2020 into 2021 really provides for us. What God's wanting to see through our lives, us letting go and now raising, being raised up into something unique and new.
Yeah.
And those are promises we're to walk into, but yet you and I have to let go of some things. And here's the thing, it's not going to be a big thing. It's a gigantic thing, but I'm not here to give you 15 different points. We're not here to talk about 15 different things. It's one thing I believe the Lord's really put in our heart, and we need to be ready to let go of unforgiveness. Now, there's a lot packed into that, and I think that's a powerful word, packed, because it's a package, it's baggage.
Right.
How should we say it? It's something that honestly is an obstacle that gets stuck in our path and keeps us from being able to move forward. The word is very clear when it's related to unforgiveness, and how that we can pray all day long, but honestly, we can pray, but we will still remain unforgiven ourselves if we have unforgiveness in our heart. The word actually says to leave. If you're praying, to leave and go and make things right, come back, then ask God.
Mm-hmm.
Because if we're somewhere in our heart at a point of offense, hurt, unforgiveness, that honestly what takes place is that our prayers are somehow stuck. They're not able to fully, not that God can't hear, God can hear, but the word says he'll not forgive us unless
right.
we're willing to forgive others.
Right.
And so he will not somehow, you know, make it easy for you, but then hold the rest of us, you know, to some level of expectation, but then lower the bar for you or lower the bar for me. He'll not bypass his own word or his law to say, look, here's the bar, forgive, and you're operating in my presence. And as you forgive, then forgiveness also is expressed and given to you. That's the thing we got to let go of on this side, because in letting go of something on this side, it allows us to cross over with authority.
That's right. That's right. I think, you know, you kind of can think of it like this, like a boulder or like almost like a mountain in your way. It's going to be really hard to get where you need to go if you're harboring, if you're holding on, or as you said, if you're lugging around the baggage of unforgiveness, it's going to be really hard to get to your next position, your next destination.
You know, I right now feel I'm assuming as we begin to talk about this, it didn't take much for you to already see that face. I mean, to think of that person,
yeah.
or persons, or that situation, or that issue, or that circumstance that was thrust upon you. That you were not prepared for, folks that took advantage of you, or maybe needing to forgive yourself because of something that you did knowingly or unknowingly, but you feel the guilt.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the thing about forgiveness and unforgiveness. It's something that that you can self-impose
right.
because you can't forgive yourself.
Right.
And then it's something too that you can't release someone else. And honestly, we become the jail. The jailer and the one jailed.
Mm-hmm.
And so ultimately we have to not only let someone else go, if they know it or they don't, that, you know, we tend to think they're thinking fully about it, that they can't get it out of their mind like we can't get it out of theirs, out of ours,
the case.
Right?
It's only affecting us. It usually doesn't even affect them. They're able to go on. We're the ones that get stuck.
Right. But that allows us, because we're the jailer, we're holding the cell door shut on them, which is also holding the door shut on us.
Right.
But as that jailer, we're able to, hey, let it go. Now, let it go, drop the baggage, allow those things that have been blocking us from moving into the next level blessing, to drop those things so that we're able to step over, and then we're freeing ourselves. Here's a powerful word. We're pardoning ourselves, but being willing to pardon someone else. You know, the Bible speaks
right.
about it where Jesus is giving that great prayer when they said, teach us to pray. And he spoke and said at one portion of it, forgive those that have offended you, just as you know you have forgiven, you know, that you need to be forgiven because you've offended others. He said, forgive us our sins and forgive those who've sinned against us.
Right.
That's what Jesus said. And he started with us and not the ones that we tend to think of right now, or maybe many of you have already thought of the person right now that the Holy Spirit's challenging you to let go of that, to extend forgiveness, to let it go, and to allow the grace of the Holy Spirit to actually cover it. Because you know what? Unforgiveness is actually, or should I say, forgiveness, to forgive is an unnatural thing. It is more natural to not give, to not give up, to not forgive.
Yeah.
What do they say? It's a dog-eat-dog world. It's not a dog-forgive-dog world.
Yeah.
So it is what? It's not a natural thing
no,
for us to give. It's
no.
more of an unnatural thing that really is only empowered by the grace of God, right?
Amen. Amen. You know, a lot of times when you think about unforgiveness, I think even in the context of this new year, we're in 2020 right now, we're going to 2021, and you think about nothing changes from this year to next year. Unless we change, it has to be us.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just because a number changes on a calendar doesn't change where you're walking out of and what you're walking into. It comes down to us being the ones who have to make that change. So I truly believe that unforgiveness, what you're talking about right now, is something that if we can operate in unforgiveness, I believe there can be a great change in our lives as we enter into this new year.
Well, if we're operating in unforgiveness, then it's going to have us stuck. A grudge is going to hold us where we are. But if we operate in forgiving and extending that sense of forgiveness, here's what the word says in Matthew 6 and 15. Jesus said, if you do not forgive, then your Father will not forgive you. That's why we have to operate in that, because honestly, it will shut us down from being able to move into those new things that God has for us. So we've got to let it go. Just begin to say that, Lord, Lord, help me to let go of the baggage, let go of the offense, let go of the frustration, because it's not natural. It requires a supernatural grace to gift you to begin to flow in that. And Ryan, and we're gonna pray just in a moment that will begin to happen in your life, that you'll begin to feel the grace of God right now at the end of this year, moving into next year, to flow over you so that you're able to do something Amen. That you're not able to do in the natural.
Amen.
It's not just a decision that's made. It's not just one day you wake up on the right side of the bed and now you're able to forgive others. No, and honestly, you need to realize this too, that the enemy's goal is to create disunity.
That's right.
The devil is out to create disunity, to divide,
right.
to get between husband and wife, get between children and parents. And
to subtract or divide, never to add to or to multiply or to cause growth. It's always to take from, right?
And ultimately, it is to divide us from God, because God operates in the spirit of unity. We know that in the upper room, I mean, they were all in one accord, mm-hmm. focused on God's mm-hmm. plan. The Holy Spirit filled the atmosphere of that room and changed the world. God moves in that. One of our favorite scriptures is found there in Psalm 133. Just a couple of verses. It's a bedrock verse for our church, or a couple of verses for our church. It talks the power of unity, how blessed it is for brethren to dwell together in unity.
That's right.
It talks about this, how that blessings are commanded where
That's right.
there's a sense of harmony. And that's where multiple things, think of a symphony where there's yeah. many different types of instruments of all different styles mm-hmm. and flavors, woodwind, brass, you know. Well, you know, you're
timpani.
See, I knew you'd know that right there. Timpani.
Timpani.
I was thinking Tiffany. Who's Tiffany? But you put all that together and it creates a wonderful harmonic symphony of sound
yeah.
that works together to create something beautiful. That's the way God operates. But the enemy wants to create noise.
Right.
And to disunify so that all there is static and noise and we're unable to hear the voice of God and see
yeah.
clearly. So, I mean, I'm telling you, I really believe that God wants to speak something to those that will have ears to hear January the 3rd, crossover into the promise. But he's preparing those right now that are able to hear to let go of the baggage so you're able now to cross over, to get over that Jordan into your promised land. That's God's destiny for us.
Amen. Yes, it is.
That's God's plans for us. But to let go of something isn't a natural thing. It has to be God's super on your natural, his grace applied to your hardened heart. And I shouldn't just say yours, to our hardened
yeah.
hearts,
yeah.
our grudges, our
sure.
frustrations, our things that really did happen. Some folks think that to forgive, you got to deny the fact. No, it just puts it in the hands of God, where God's the righteous judge. And there is accountability, but you don't hold the reins. Let God take care of it. God will work it out all together for
Amen.
Good.
That's right.
But when we begin to get our hands involved, it just gets too messy and it gets too cluttered. And honestly, it's not going to be something that's healthy or has a God goal that's accomplished, right?
That's right. That's exactly right.
Do you know what? That unforgiveness as well. Hear this. Unforgiveness is unhealthy. I mean, actually physically, it is unhealthy that enzymes are created that actually feed the wrong things that are there inside of us, and it can create out of it health issues.
That's right.
Blood pressure,
I was
going to
say,
like
blood
this.
Pressure. There's all kinds of different things that it can affect, and harboring unforgiveness in your heart, in your life, mm-hmm. in your mind, if you will, in your spirit, it only creates problems even internally for you, right?
Right.
Physically.
Well, the enzymes feed the things, and that will, of course, create ailments. So it's amazing how that it begins a spiritual thing, but then obviously it manifests itself in a physical or even a mental way, because it
yeah.
can not only affect us physically, we're
yeah.
ailments. I mean, because what happens at the beginning of all of our years? We all want to get healthy. Well, if you really want to get healthy, think about it. Attack the spiritual things first, and it manifests
That's right.
in your physical life.
That's exactly right.
Get rid of the emotional baggage of unforgiveness. And watch and see if also there might not be a little bit of weight lost in the natural, you know, or pounds
yeah.
that are lost. But ultimately,
if
it's unhealthy.
Not, it definitely lifts the weight off your spirit,
That's
right?
True.
I mean,
That's true.
It definitely lifts the weight.
We all want to be healthy, but you know what? Actually, unforgiveness it will rob you of life.
Yeah.
It robs you of life, and it takes years off of your life. I mean, it literally, factually, shortens your life. So what we're talking about, those things that are allowing us to cross over, what? To fulfill the purpose that God has for us, to not end it 5 years short because we still love God, but yet we're not able to fulfill our purpose because there's just still some things that are kind of stuck in our heart that we're not able to let go of.
Mm-hmm.
We're not able to release. And so we have to be willing to receive the grace of God, which is His super on our natural, because we just can't forgive because we made up our mind to forgive. No, it's something that we need the enabling power of the Holy Spirit to do. And then secondly, realize that it's going to be impactful not only to our spirit, but also to our natural man. Our year is going to be healthier, body, mind, soul, and spirit, because honestly, we've let go of some things that have kept us on the wrong side of our blessing. Our blessing's over here, but we're just seeing it, but we're not able to experience it because God has a crossover blessing for our life into the promise, but we've got to let go of some things, and only God's really able to allow us to let go of it. Let me read this scripture to you. It's powerful. It's found in Philippians chapter 3, verse 13 through 14, and it says, "But one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things which are ahead, I press toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus." Movement is life. And the way we move forward and step into the promise that God has for us, that I'll talk about on that first Sunday in the new year, is letting go of the things that just get stuck in our heart that the enemy knows his goal is to create disunity. And first and foremost, he wants to what? Separate you from God. And if God says, "I'm not even hearing your prayers if you're not going to go and let somebody off the hook, because I let you off the hook.
Yeah.
So go let them off the hook and then come back and pray and I hear you every time." He's going to try to disunify, keep us in disunity from God and then from one another. And then before you know it, what happens is unforgiveness is a very isolated, just you, yourself, and I.
Yeah. Yeah.
Kind of experience.
Yeah.
And it keeps us from friends. It keeps us from relationships. And then we begin to start pointing fingers instead of allowing the Holy Spirit to speak to us. And it's dangerous. I said a moment ago, it's physically takes years off your life. It's lethal. It's lethal in every aspect.
Amen. It is. I know the enemy loves nothing more than to get us isolated, get us on our own by ourselves, because then what happens? Then that's where, when we're by ourselves and we don't have, you know, the accompanying, you know, friend or brother or husband,
right,
wife, what happens is then we just turn inward on ourselves. We start letting our mind rule, our thoughts start to rule where we are and what we're dealing with. And it's just nothing more than destruction the enemy causes, nothing more than that when you're isolated.
Well, and I've heard it said this way, and I love it. I love this idea that we are never more like God than when we give.
Mm.
We're never more,
yeah,
like God than when we give. Well,
yeah.
What's the little part of that word we're asking you? But here, listen, not only you, but also us. I can think right now of some folks and situations and things that, you know, honestly, we all have it. I can take the total sum of my 365, carry the one, and I can think of a couple of things and situations where I have to be willing to forgive.
Mm-hmm.
And in that word, forgive, is that word give. We're never more like God than when we give. And one way that we give is we forgive.
Amen.
Have to extend that, because as we extend it, then of course it makes its way to us. Because ultimately, as I was saying just a moment ago, that grudges, they only isolate us from people who we once were friends with. They,
yeah,
actually shorten our life. Unforgiveness, it produces those deadly enzymes that contribute to the physical, but then we also know even the mental and emotional just ailments that create the drift in our life where we drift apart.
Mm-hmm.
Naturally, just kind of from the things we limit in our life, the result is a drifting apart. But forgiveness, what it does, it reverses that cycle. It reverses, you know, maybe the fountain of youth is to forgive, you know, to let go and watch as things begin to, sure, do all those other good things too, you know, but ultimately, it reverses things. It changes things. It begins to restore things that we need to see restored. You know, ultimately, Jesus in Matthew chapter 22, verse 37 through 39, he was asked the question, "What's the greatest commandment?" He said, "The greatest commandment is to first love God, and then mm-hmm. secondly, love your neighbor as yourself." The neighbor is the ones that has the closeness to us, the proximity. They're the ones that can hurt us and harm us. But he says to love God and then love your neighbor.
Mm-hmm.
And in giving that love, genuine and authentic love, then honestly, we're never more like God than when we give. But if we don't have love, isn't it 1 Corinthians that talks about all these amazing things that we can do that seem like it's giving, but if at our heart,
1 Corinthians 13, yeah,
it's not love,
yeah,
then it's a sounding brass. What? Yeah. What's the thing? Yeah, I think you know it.
I would say clanging cymbal, which reminds me of what you said earlier when you talked about the noise and the static. It's a bunch of just noise and static if we don't have love operating in our life. And in our life, through love, being, you know, being able to operate in that place of forgiveness.
But I will tell you this, and I think I might have said it up earlier, but if you're looking for offense or if you're a fault finder, you're never going to run out of the offenses.
Oh, it'll always
you're
be
never
there.
Going to run out of the faults. The faults to be found. Jesus said offenses will come, meaning
that's
that
right.
Not if they or when, maybe. No, he said they're coming.
They're going to come.
But then if we can't stop it, we don't have the choice to stop it. We have the choice to not grab a hold of it, to take it and hold it tight.
Right.
And ultimately, the enemy uses that to keep us stuck on this side of our blessing. So we're challenging you to let go of the things, to release those things that have been blocking the blessing of God in your life so that you and I are able to choose to cross over into the promise of what God has for us. You know, 2020 has created a lot of opportunities for folks to be offended, to be frustrated. Some of them are real and they need God to be involved in, and God is involved.
Yeah.
Doesn't mean that we're saying that they're figments of folks' imagination. No. One thing about 2020, we've talked about at the beginning, 2020 vision, you know, and I don't remember what I said. I'm sure I was like most saying, we've got clarity and vision for the year. And I think really instead of a 2020 vision, I think what we're looking at now is what hindsight is 2020.
Yeah.
Reflecting on this year, looking back and realizing that what we thought we knew,
we didn't know.
We didn't know a whole lot. But one thing that we did know is that you can trust in God, and
that's
God
right.
has brought us to this point, and
He's been truly
faithful. So I'd hate to say that here we are at the edge, and that's where we are. We're at the edge of a blessing, stepping over and crossing over. And we're getting ready here in just a moment to pray out this year and thank God for the new.
Yeah.
But wouldn't you hate to get to this point and have all of this experience, but also be kept back and not let go of the thing that you need to let go of and move into the place where God, not just into a new year, you know, a page turned in the natural. No, but to really, right, but to really know it's more than that. It's bigger than that. We're stepping into something new. 2021 is not our savior.
No,
God is our savior. You know, I heard the quick little story and illustration, you know, of the group that showed up. They had a big giant shredder, and they brought all the things that they wanted to get rid of as they were stepping into the new year. One gal brought the picture of her ex-fiance with his new girlfriend. She shredded it, and she felt better about it.
Good for her.
One guy showed up, and his doctor's report that had his high blood pressure and cholesterol and all this kind of stuff, and he shredded it. And so the giant shredder did its job, but you know, in reality, it really didn't change a whole lot of things.
Yeah.
But you and I are not sitting here at the end of this year hoping that somehow a giant shredder has some mystical capability. We're realizing that it's not a giant shredder that we need to put our faith in. It's a great Savior that we put our faith in.
Amen.
And so at the end of this year, the great Savior not only brought us this far, but He's also going to lead us forward, because movement in God is life.
That's
it's
right.
Faith leaning forward. We're leaning into what God has for us.
That's right.
And as we do that, we let go of these things, looking forward, pressing in, knowing that God is for us. Then who can, truly, who can be
That's
against
right.
us? And so let's not have all of this somehow have us stepping into something new, still stuck with that old stuff, expecting better things, but we still have that weight holding us down.
Yeah, amen.
You know, I'm kind of in with this, and it's a tragic story, but I think it's a great example to finish with, as we're going to have the Katinas, who we love so much, sing one of your favorite songs, right?
Mm, Peace, Love, Hallelujah, right?
That's right. How do they do it? How do they do it?
It's Peace, Love, Hallelujah.
That's right. I love that part. Yeah. So Peace,
Put me
Love,
on the spot.
Hallelujah. You did great, though. Did great. But I read the story of a family, and you know, one of the hurricanes this past year here in the States, we had many of them, but that they were able to ride out, you know, the hurricane. They survived the hurricane. But tragically enough, because they had a generator that was operating to maintain, you know, while things were so dark and stormy, that they survived the storm, but then they later, tragically enough, died from the fumes of the generator.
Yeah.
It could be that for many, that literally we ride out this storm of 2020, but we don't let go of forgiveness or the things we picked up that we're angry about or frustrated with, we've not given to God and put that situation in God's hands. And the fumes of that literally consume us. We were not able to really step into the blessing that God has for us.
Yeah.
Here we are at the end of this year saying, hey, we've ridden through the storm through 2020. There might be some lingering effects into 2021. In the natural corona and many other things, we don't know how that's all going to work out, but we trust in God. And those who keep their mind on God, Isaiah 26:3, they have perfect peace, which is that word shalom, shalom. Listen, we can be in shalom, shalom, perfect peace if we have our eyes on God.
Amen.
Jeremiah 29:11, his plans towards us are good and not evil, but to give us a future and to give us a hope. We're riding it out. We're finishing this year. We might have to ride out a little bit more. But in the name of Jesus, we'll not be consumed. We'll not get to the end of this and then somehow say we made it. And then the fumes of what's left and lingers kill us, consume us spiritually. Yeah. So God is good. He's faithful.
So good.
We hope you receive that. We're going to come back here just in a moment. We're going to celebrate as this year is ending and the new year is beginning. But enjoy the Katinas as they lead you in a great song, one of our favorites.
Peace, love, hallelujah.
Say peace. Feel the love. Now say hallelujah. Say.
If not for your mercy, if not for your grace, I don't know where I'd be, alone on happy days. I thank you for your mercy. I thank you for your grace. I smile cause I feel much better than okay.
Surpasses all understanding. Peace around the world, goodwill to men, yo.
If not for your mercy, if not for your grace, don't know where I'd be, low on happy days. I thank you for your mercy, I thank you for your grace. I smile cause I feel much better than okay. Peace, love, hallelujah. My hands up to ya, dancing all the day long. Give it up. Peace, love, hallelujah. But I give it to ya, singing, this is my song.
Yes, exactly.
I'm gonna give it all back to you.
Never gonna stop.
Never gonna stop. I'm gonna give it all back to you. Oh yeah, oh yeah, yeah. I'm gonna give it all back to you. Never ever gonna stop. Gonna give it all back to you.
I'll rap the world, say
peace, love, hallelujah. Put my hands up to ya, dancing all the day long.
When I sing to the dance, yes I be.
Peace, love, hallelujah. But I give it to ya, sing it, this is my song.
Everybody give it up.
Gonna give it all back to you.
Never gonna stop.
Never ever gonna stop.
Everybody give it
gonna
up.
Give it all.
Enjoyed that song. We love the Katinas.
Yes,
they've been so great to be with us all through December. And, you know, peace, love, hallelujah. I can't think of a better way or a better song to really end on is now we're going to pray over you, pray some things off you, pray some things over you, and then we're going to step into our new year.
Amen. Amen. You want to start it?
All right. All right. You start.
All right. Father, we thank you right now, Lord, at the culmination of this year, Lord, that you've kept us and you've sustained us, Lord. We thank you that you've given us health when we've needed it, Lord. You've given us patience when we've needed it, God. You've supplied every need we've had, Lord, throughout this year. Lord, we know that as we're stepping into a new year, We know that a number doesn't change, Lord, what's going on in our mm-hmm. world. It may not even change the suffering that we have to walk through a little bit longer, but God, we know you are there.
Amen.
And Lord, we know that we depend on our Savior. That's who you are to us. So Lord, as we enter into this new year, bless your people, God. Keep Amen. Your hand on your people, Lord. God, continue to sustain us as we are moving forward in you, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name, movement Jesus is life. Name. And we step forward in faith, believing that. And now, Father, I pray for the grace to be applied to all of our lives so that we can do what Lord. Is not possible in the natural. Lord, let us let go of the grudges. Forgive those where there need to be forgiveness. Lord, even allow us to forgive ourselves, Lord, as we just lay some things down. Lord, we can't shred things away, but we can seek you, our great Savior. So, Father, we thank you for it. Bless your people. Keep your hand on your people. Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we declare a new experience over you as you cross over into the promises of God. We're going to the other side, right?
Amen.
All right.
Amen.
All right, good stuff. So we've got some stuff here, some things like this, of course. So, Happy New Year! Happy New Year, church. We love you. Appreciate
you.
We love you so much.
Oh,
wow.
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year! Happy New Year! Happy New Year! Happy New Year! Happy New Year!
Love you! Hey, we're good? Yeah. Oh, we're done.
Put it on right there.
Okay, no more because you're getting it all over all my stuff.